dearest.
My dear. Look at me.
Money and breeding.
Oh,
did you? She's dead now. You can tell me the truth.
Honey, how can you?
Must I remind
I did have a master.
I shouldn't have said that. I'm sorry.
I long to die. All I want is to see you happy, the sort of son she would have hoped for. Elizabeth is nice, but she's not for you. Father at times, but you mean so much to me. God bless you, my boy.
God speak, you slut! You spoke of my place. Aren't you Gretchen forgetting yours? Or did you hire me? Is it your job to procure for master? Excuse my asking.
See you up again. You ought to eat more and work less.
Kiss me, I'm not hungry.
Careful.
Where is our ex-prophetess?
In the Gasthaus, I imagine, drinking schnapps and playing skirt. Naturally, the guides will cheat her, but she likes it.
So, that's that.
Aren't you going to tell him?
When I got right, I find food the only consolation.
Tell me, what a filthy mind that a woman has! Let her give the information! I must not get into shadow! I must not forget my station!
Still, I think we ought to tell him!
Master, don't you think you really need peace and solitude? How can you work or concentrate or read from me when certain people...
Certain people? I hate sly insinuations. Who?
And don't you think it would be best if you talked to Father?
Elizabeth, of course, for one. Who else?
He's so upset and worried. I'm, you see, he's on his arm.
Well?
I didn't want to tell you, but...
You're longing, I can see, to tell me about her and Tony. Well, that's hardly news to me.
Kissing him in public places.
Better than behind locked doors.
What are we to do?
Let the children play, of course.
Must we talk so much? But, Master...
Since you have no sense of taste, ask Elizabeth to join me. These muffins are too good to waste.
Darling. Kiss me when I ask you. No, I don't feel like kissing anyone.
she will. She won't.
Excuse my interrupting what must be an important conversation. The master says that he would like Elizabeth to join him now at tea. I didn't tell him anything.
Let me come with you.
No, I've questions of my own to settle. I must handle them alone.
Sit down, dear child. Are you cross with me?
No, not cross.
But you were, weren't you, my dear? Angry with me for my anger at you when you told Hilda about her husband.
Me, I minded. I thought you unjust to her.
And you were right. I was unjust. And why?
Because you only thought of yourself. Always do.
No, there you make a mistake. I was angry for the sake of an unmade verse, crying out to be made.
But surely you ought to have put her good before any thought of what she could do.
Boom.
bull who repeats his stories. A spoiled child who stamps and screams when his will is crossed. And then, oh dear, the atmosphere surrounding him, the adoration, the force. How ridiculous! How humorless it looks to you, doesn't it? Yes.
Nevertheless, believe it or not, I need all this to protect and save the tiny store of what we need. Perception. But you cannot know, have any conception of what it is like to be a poet. Of what it means never, never to feel, to think, to see, to hear. Reflecting, no, could I use that somehow? Would it translate into number and rhyme? Until in time, no one longer knows what is true and false, or right and wrong. Only what goes and won't go to song. Performing again, shall I never learn to stop it? Elizabeth, my dear, forgive me.
It is I who need forgiveness. Ready for you. There's clean foolscap. It's five, nearly.
Bless you, my child.
Carolina. I'm sorry I upset you. You upset me! Kindly mind your own troubles and don't try and poke your nose into those of others.
Thank you. Did you tell him?
No.
What, dear? Why not? One of us must, after all.
After all, perhaps there is nothing to tell. What could I tell him? Nothing he does know already. And what do we know, Tony, about each other?
We know, we love each other.
Tony, I know I loved my father. Then I thought I loved your godfather. Then...
Elizabeth, your voice is so strange. What has happened? You're not yourself.
Not. Perhaps I never was. Was I myself when I dreamed of becoming his mistress?
Please don't.
The dream came true, but didn't it? Like in the fairy tales, the goose girl won her prince. She was supposed to live happily ever after. But something happened.
The spell of the old sorcerer was broken. That's what happened. The shepherd boy beheld the princess. He knew he would love her forever.
Oh, she heard him say he loved her. Did you say that? Oh, was she under a new spell?
Do you love me, or don't you?
Tony, dear, please listen. I don't think I can leave him.
What do you mean?
Try to understand. There are some women, perhaps, who can only feel what a wife should for an older man.
No! You can't mean that. I don't believe it. I won't. It's not you speaking. That devil must have hypnotized you. But I'll put a stop to that. We must get this right.
Mr. Reichmann. You might know the master is not to be interrupted.
The Mittenhofer will damn well do as I wish.
It's the wrong time.
Tony!
It's late enough for me. It's now. I'll see him.
You may, Tony. You do. No need to fuss.
It's all right, Lena. What's come over us? We're not in a palace here, or in a school. There's no need for rebellion, or for protocol.
I love Elizabeth, she said she loved me. Then suddenly, she said she didn't know. I want to know what's happened. Afraid to offend the great white god, or afraid of him, well, now he knows. Elizabeth, tell them, tell them,
tell them. For the great master, he's a boy, has nothing to love. Growing, it's bad for him.
Conventionalities don't suit us. Tell me openly your feelings, as I asked you to, and with no fear that I may be too selfish or too weak to hear.
Forgive him, master, it won't do.
Have you forgotten? Tony is my son too. He's fallen in love. I can't see why that needs forgiving. Oh, why, dear child, if you love my son, knowing how near my heart is, you still are shy.
If I could say,
forgive. did think Tony self-deceived. The self-deception was my own. I'd say no more if I believed you weak. The scene's intolerable, still you're not called upon to choose between two more. But to fulfill the woman, or remain amused.
Ellis must know, it's more than that to me. If you can't say you love me when it's true,
if you can't say
you
love me,
nothing,
you
will not
show me nothing. My son,
come on,
if I may. Villain, I can guess why you do. Surely, it's more important we both know there isn't anyone who'd better nurse our son. Admit your reasons are passé, my friend, and as my friend, have faith in me. Bless them. You will, hearing that prophecy, their love fulfills for us. I'll tell you of the poem I'm working on called The Young Lovers.
Forget the hour when nothing can root, nothing will flower.
Thank you, Father.
No more now, please.
say to you, Gregor, I'm ashamed.
Ah, you see, my dear, I meant you to be. I can be sly, you know, and at this stage, having a boon to beg you, I imagined shame would smooth away to having you comply.
A spring.
One more day.
One day.
In some few days, my dears, I shall be 60. Foolishly, perhaps, I had hoped by then to have finished an opus yours, the young lovers, in order to have it ready to read on my birthday. Help me, both of you, from the flanks of the hammer home, bring me Edelweiss, a visionary aid I've often found effective when all else failed. Don't chide my childishness by refusing my dears, or mock me. Remain here one more day.
Tomorrow, may we gratefully repay you. like it.
No, no. These two are my tonic today. I don't need it.
Tomorrow is the front.
Master, your day's been broken.
No, no, it's too late now. Just leave me to ponder my nonsense.
Mittenhover, I've had no time this month to find you some Edelweiss, but I forecast tomorrow's weather as warm enough.
Never mind. I shan't need any. Thank you for your thoughtfulness.
Good night.
Good night. Guinea pig to make him famous and make a newly rich his motherless whelp. That rutting little pig who imagines it's rebellion to disobey his father once. And the fatherless bitch who found a papa dog from whom to run away. Why don't they just blow up and disappear?